हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। टुडे आई एम कंटिन्यूइंग अगेन द सीरीज कंसेप्ट। ओके, सो टुडे टू शो बेसिक डिटेल्स ऑफ सीरीज। ओके, सो फॉर दिस पर्पस हियर आई एम यूजिंग इम्पोर्ट pandas as pd. okay, here I am using numpy array. So here you must import numpy as np, because here I want to create a series with the help of numpy 1d array to create a pandas series with 1d numpy array. Okay, so here np dot array in bracket I am using simple 10 20 and 30. Okay, now here I am using s is equal to pd dot series. Here I am passing na and print s. Now control s, f5, you can see the output. So here na is in numpy 1d array, because here I am creating series with the help of numpy 1d array. Okay, so 10 20 30, this is a value. Okay, but suppose you want to display the size of a series, so we can use print s dot size. Okay, control s, f5, you can see this is the output here. 3 means the total number of elements in this. Total number of element is 3. Okay, to display the shape of a series, so here I'm writing print s dot shape. Okay, shape means total number of rows and column, because series is only a support only single row. Okay, so it is very difficult, so we can say, but when we use data frame, so it will display total number of rows with total number of columns, but here it will display only the total number of elements. Okay, so you control s, f5, so you can see, again you can see 3 comma means only this is only 3 elements, we can say. Okay, we cannot determine ki 3 rows and columns, we can only determine only 3 elements. So the output of size and same in a series mostly same. Okay, to display all the values of a series, we can use s dot values. Okay, control s, f5, you can see the last output is 10 20 30. We can also use print s for this purpose, or we can also use s dot values to show the same output. Now to display the dimension of a series, print s dot ending. Okay, so here, because series only supports single row, so the dimension is only one dimension, but in data frame looks like a table. So in a table we can say two dimension, one dimension for rows and second dimension for column, but series only a one single line of data, we can say single row of data, or we can say single column of data. So we can say only one dimension. But in pandas, in future we will discuss, it looks like a table. So table have two dimension, one for row and second for column. So here dimension is 1. To display the axis of a series means index range. Okay, index range. So here I am writing print s dot axis, control s, s5. So you can see the last value is range index. Okay, because our index start from 0 and stop 3 and step 1. So axis will display the output of hash to display data types of a series, because you can see in our series only a simple integer values. Only simple integer means there is no decimal point, there is a simple integer value. So the data types of our s variable which already hold these values, so we can display the data types print s dot dt types. Okay, in this control s f5, so you can see finally the integer 32. Integer 32 means the 10 integer 32 data type, 20 also integer 32 data type, and 30 also integer 32 data. So it will give the information of data types of our values. Okay, so there is a one thing is important in this. We direct use size, shape, values, axis and data types. Okay, we cannot use after a bracket. Only simple directly we can use s dot size, s dot shape, s dot value, s dot axis and data types. Now I want to perform some statistical operations, so we can use a bracket. So to display sum of a series value, so here I am writing print s dot sum. Okay, control s f5. So you can see 60. Okay, so our final output is 60. Okay, you can see 60 is our final output because it will sum the all the values of our series. Okay, so to display maximum value of a series, so we here I am using print s dot max function. Here this bracket is important. Okay, control s f5. So you can see maximum value is 30. Okay, so I want to copy and paste. Here I am using mean. Mean means minimum value. So you can see minimum value. So control s f5. So minimum value is, we know very well, is 10. Okay, now I want to display count values of a series. So here I am using count function. Okay, here I am using count, control s f5. So it will count because total number of 3. So you can see s dot count, s dot size, s dot shape will give the same result. Okay, to display variance of a series, so here I am writing variance value. Okay, print s dot var. Okay, control as F5. So you can see the variance of 10, 20 and 30 in statistical term. In statistical, it is a standard formula, or based on this formula, inside variance have a standard formula. So after using this formula, Python will yield this result 100. Okay, so to display standard deviation of a series means we can say the square root of variance, it will result standard deviation. So we can use print s dot std control s f5. So the square root, this is a variance, the square root of 10. So we can say the square root of variance will a standard deviation. Okay, to display the all aggregation of series values, all types of aggregation we can display directly. Here I am using print s dot describe. Okay, so describe is a very powerful function. It will display minimum, max, sum, count, also quartile. Quartile means 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. Okay, so we can directly see the all types of above output. So you can see count, mean, mean means average, standard deviation, minimum 25% of data, 50% maximum, or also the final output. So describe, it will display the all type of statistics. Okay, we can also display the average of value to display average of a series value. So we can use print s dot mean. So 10 plus 20 plus 30, it will display the average value. So average value is here 20. Using a describe function, or separately we can also perform 20. Okay, so today student, when we have a set of value, okay, we can store in a list concept, in a 1D array, or we can also store this value in a series, pandas series, because pandas series provides so much type of facility, 1D array and list cannot provide. So we can use pandas series concept. So we can perform a statistical function, we can display size, shape, values, dimension, axis, data, this kind of information. We can also perform aggregation function, sum, max, mean, count, variance, standard deviation, describe and mean average function. Okay students, hope you enjoy this video. Thank you so much.